With Amazon EBS, you can use any of the standard RAID configuration that you can use with a traditional bare metal server, as long as that particular RAID configuration is supported by the operating system for your instance. Funny, I spoke about a lot of confusing terms. Don't worry about this. We will get into the details of all of this. If you aren't aware of RAID, it's not Ajay Devgan's movie RAID. It's a storage configuration. So what RAID means is redundant array of independent disks. And remember that redundant does not mean repetitive. I take a lot of interviews, and when I ask about redundancy, most of the people tell me as it being repetitive. So in coding terms as well, if you write a new code that is a bit different but does the same job, then you make the older code or the older one that you have obsolete or unnecessary. So here, if you write a new function that is different, and here I'm talking in terms of being repetitive. So both are different codes, but they do the same thing, making the previous one redundant. So that is the same reason why there is a saying that don't create the wheel, use it. So let's come back to RAID. So RAID is redundant array of independent disks. And here you employ the technique of stripping, mirroring, or parity to create large reliable data stores from multiple general purpose computer hard disk drives or HDDs. And RAID is a data storage visualization technology that combines multiple physical disk drive components into one or more logical units for the purpose of data redundancy, performance improvement, or both. Okay, let's decipher these three terms that we have: stripping, mirroring, and parity, so that it'll help you understand the type of RAID configuration that we are going to discuss moving forward. So the first one that is we have here is data stripping. So data stripping is the technique of segmenting logically sequential data, such as a file, so that consecutive segments are stored on different physical storage devices. So in simple term, it's like you divide them logically and sequentially and store them into different physical drives. And the second one that we have here is data mirroring. Data mirroring is the replication of logical disk volumes into separate physical hard drives in real time to ensure continuous availability. A mirror volume is a complete logical representation of separate volume copies. So as you know, mirroring means keeping the replica of it into different drives so that you have high availability. And the third one that you have is a parity bit or check bit. Here, a parity bit or a check bit is added to a string of binary code to ensure that the total number of 1 bits in the string is even or odd. So parity in English term means equality, uniformness, consistency, or sameness. So in networking terms, a parity bit or a check bit is a bit added to a string of binary code to ensure that the total number of 1s in the string is even or odd. So parity bits are used often for error detection. Let's take a small example here. So if you have the actual value of 1100 and we add a parity of 1, and the sender has sent 11001, and if the receiver receives 11001, then you say that the information received is correct. And in the second example that we have, if the actual value is 1100 and the parity was added as 0, and the sender has sent 11000 and the receiver receives 11001, then there is a mismatch and that is an incorrect state of information that was received. So basically this was used for error detection. And mostly when you have error detection in place, you can measure the effectiveness of the information that you have received. And equality of data can also be measured with parity bits. So there are four type of RAID configurations that we are going to discuss here. Let's start off with RAID 0. So RAID 0 is basically stripping. I hope you remember the term stripping. In RAID 0, system data are split up into blocks that get written across all the drives in the array. By using multiple disks, at least 2, at the same time, this offers superior I/O performance. So here if you see, we have block 1 data in disk 1, block 2 data in disk 2, and sequentially we store in different drives. So block 1, block 2, block 3, block 4, block 5, block 6, they are divided into 2 drives and they have been stored sequentially. So what are the advantages then? So RAID 0 offers great performance both in read and write operation. There is no overhead caused by the parity controls because there is no parity bit used, and all storage capacity is used. And the disadvantages that we have is RAID 0 is not fault tolerance. So if OneDrive fails, all the data in the RAID 0 array is lost. It should not be used for mission critical systems, because if you lose data, you are dead. I mean, it's not literally dead, but job wise. Moving on. So in RAID 1, that is mirroring. So data here are stored twice by writing them to both the disk drives or the data drives or the set of data drives that we have and the mirror drive or the set of drives that we have. And if the drive fails, the controller uses either of the data drives or the mirror drives for data recovery and continues the operation. So if you see here, we have data that is in block 1 is stored in both the drives, drive 1 and drive 2. And similar thing goes for all the other blocks. And it creates a mirror effect for the data in both the drives. So you have block 1 repeated in both the drives, block 2, block 3, block 4 and block 5 available to you in both the drives. This is mirroring technique and this is the RAID level 1. So what are the advantages that we have here? RAID 1 offers excellent read speed and write speed. In case of drive fails, data does not have to be rebuilt. They just have to be copied from the replacement drive. The best thing is all of the data capacity or the storage capacity is used. So the disadvantage that you have is effective storage capacity is only half of the total drive capacity. And the failed drive can only be replaced after powering down the system or the computer it is attached to. And for multiple access, this may not be good. So what happens here is even if you have both the drives available to you, as you have created the replica of each of the data that you have in the drive 1 into drive 2, it's like using one drive itself, but you have two drives for fault tolerance and data recovery. RAID 5 is one of the secure RAID configurations. It at least has three drives and can work up to 16 drives. So if you see the drives below, we have data being divided into different drives, and on one drive a parity checksum of all the block data is written. You see the red block there, it's the parity block and are separated across all the drives. So here in case there is a loss of data, the system can recalculate the block or the data block using the parity data to determine which data set it belongs to so that it becomes more secure. So if there is any failure, what happens is that it has to read the data from all the drives and connect each of them to get you the data that you have lost. So what are the advantages here? The read data transactions are very fast, while write data transactions are somewhat slower due to the parity that must be calculated. And if the drive fails, you still have access to all the data and it rebuilds the data on the new drive. And the disadvantages that you have is it takes a lot of time to rebuild the structure if there is a failure, and the loss of data is there if there are multiple failures, because you cannot recalculate the parity blocks or the data that you want to retrieve from the parity blocks if multiple failures are there. And moving on to the RAID 6, that is stripping with double parity. So here we have stripping of data across multiple drives and you have double parity blocks across all the drives. So what is the use of this? The use would be if there are multiple failures, like two drive fails at the same time, you will still be able to access the data. So what are the advantages that we have here? So the read data transactions are very fast, while write data transactions are somewhat slower due to the parity that must be calculated, but read transactions are very fast, so it comes as an advantage to us. If two drives fail, you still have access to all the data even while the failed drives are being replaced. So RAID 6 is much more secure than RAID 5. What are the disadvantages that we have here? So write data transactions are slower than RAID 5 due to the additional parity that must be calculated. And it takes a lot of time to rebuild the structure if there is a failure, because you have to check for all the things that you need for those two drives that have failed. And the loss of data is there if multiple failures are there. So if there are more than two drive failures, then you will have a loss of data. So out of all of these RAID configurations, only two we are going to discuss for AWS EBS. So you might ask me that, oh, EBS volumes can be replicated over multiple availability zones. So what is the use of RAID then? But what if you want to increase the IOPS? Or what if you want to have a mirror replica of EBS? To answer all your questions is the reason why EBS also provides RAID configurations, if the operating system supports it. And in EBS, RAID 0 and RAID 1 are the most commonly used configurations and which are important for the exam as well. So when it comes to RAID 0 configurations for EBS, it is backed by two or more EBS volumes and the data is stripped across multiple EBS volumes. And they are loaded sequentially and logically and thus get distributed across the volumes. You combine both the volumes and make it into one logical volume that you have. So that is, if you have 10 GB per volume, the total disk space would be 20 GB. And thus, if you have 2000 IOPS per volume, it combines and makes it 20 GB and 4000 IOPS. And the advantages and disadvantages are the same as we discussed here for RAID 0 in the previous section. And similarly, speaking about RAID 1, we have a mirror image of the data across the two volumes, and we can see them here as well. Here the difference is both are having replicas of the data, and if you have 10 GB per volume with 2000 IOPS, then in RAID 1, even if you combine both, you will still get 10 GB and 2000 IOPS. Because logically, if you see, you use only one to read or write the data.